Heyo! What's up, all you cool kids? Welcome back to another Kids Digital Service. Today's gonna be a really good one because we're gonna be talking about all the stuff that you've been watching and reading and listening to, and we're gonna help you become more like who God created you to be through all this. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna pray, we're gonna ask God to do good things inside of our hearts to make us more like Him, and then we're gonna have some fun. You guys ready to pray? Okay, quick, let's fold our hands, let's close our eyes so that we can focus on Him, and let's pray. Jesus, thank you so much that we get to gather together and hear from your word. I pray that your word would speak to us today, that it would encourage us, instruct us, challenge us, and that Holy Spirit, at the end of this video, we would know how to better make wiser decisions when it comes to the things that we watch, listen, and read. Thank you, Lord, we love you. In Jesus' name, everybody said, amen. In our last digital service, our special Easter edition, I gave you guys another digital contest, another competition. And today, we're gonna reveal our top 5 winners. I asked you guys to decorate your house in a way that lets everybody know as they come by that Jesus is alive, that He loves them, and to let everybody in your neighborhood know that this house is full of a bunch of cool Christians. And so I picked out my top 5 favorite decorated houses, the ones that I thought were, wow, these are really unique and special, that they really went like way big so that everybody can see it. And these winners, they're gonna get mailed to them a special prize pack. They're gonna get a bunch of Easter candies, some of my favorite Easter candies. You guys ready to see our top 5 winners? All right, here's the winners.
This is Aliana, and what I think is so cool about hers is that she like put a billboard in front of her house, letting everybody know that Jesus is alive, He's risen, and then where to find that in the Bible. This is Stella, and Stella, you knocked it out of the park. She did 2 things. She decorated her front window, and she had a ginormous, huge sidewalk chalk showing the cross. This is the Pearson girls. These girls, wow. I am so impressed with how big it is. I mean, it took up almost your entire driveway, and the art is really good. It's letting everybody know that Jesus is alive, that He loves them. Girls, excellent job on your sidewalk chalk. This is my guy, Mason. He went all out. He decorated his window. At night, he did this really cool thing with sparklers. And then the whole sidewalk, as people walked by, they saw that Jesus is alive and that He loves them. This is Sophia. She did a whole path of forgiveness. Here, check it out.
All of our sins that we have done, our one and only forgave us. He died on the cross for us. God loves us all very much that He rose for us. Happy Easter, everyone.
Great job, guys. I am so proud. I mean, so humongously proud of you. I mean, everybody that came by your house has heard that Jesus loves them. Oh, that's what it's all about. Great job, guys. So proud of you. To our top 5 winners, we're gonna be mailing you a box of Easter candy. That's right. Delicious, yummy, scrumdiddlyumptious candy for you to enjoy. Next, we're gonna be doing some moving and some shaking and some dancing with our bodies and singing with our voices, and we're gonna do that all for Jesus. So I want you guys to stand up, get some room. We've got 2 songs that we're gonna sing today, all to glorify God. The first song, it's a good song, it's called Great Things. It's all about the great things that Jesus does. And the second song is a Toby Mac song. It's called Everything. And it's really gonna play into our lesson in a little bit later in the video about how we can see God in everything. All right, you guys ready to worship? Let's boogie.
We'll be right back. and every beat of my heart keeps reminding me I see you in every little thing all day. No matter where I go, I know your love is finding me. I see you in everything. You're all up in everything. I see you in everything. You're all up in everything.
Yes, that song is so good. When you are focused on God, when He is the priority of your life, man, you see Him in everything. And it really helps you to be able to appreciate and even think about Him even more. Love that song. Next, I have a question I want you to ask everybody in your house. Okay, if you're gonna watch something, do you prefer to watch it on a tablet or on a TV? Which one do you choose? Would you rather watch something on a tablet or a TV? Why did you choose that one? Go ahead, talk to the people in your house. We'll be right back. In my house, unless somebody is sleeping and I'm trying to be real quiet, I want to watch it on the biggest screen possible. So I chose today my TV. While we're in this thing where we're all staying home, have you guys been doing your soap journals? If you haven't, guys, head to oakcreekag.org/kidslive after this video is done, and I want you to download the soap journal booklet for this week. What it is it's a devotional to help you read your Bible every single day. And then be able to figure out, what does that verse even mean? And how does it apply to my life? How is it gonna make me more like Jesus? So guys, if you're not doing your soap journal, guys, you should absolutely do that. You'll grow closer to Jesus as a result and be more like who He created you to be, because God's word is the best instruction for our lives. Today's video is all about watching things. And so we got a fun game that we're gonna play called YouTube Showdown. This is a super fun game that we've played at church before. What I'm gonna do is show you two different super popular YouTube videos, and what you'll have to do is, amongst everybody in your house, choose which video you think has the most views. Whoever gets the most right is the winner for today. You guys ready to play? All right, game on!
Jumpy, I wouldn't. I wouldn't hurt.
Uh-oh.
What? I want her to dance.
He does not dance.
Come on, make her dance for him.
That's not how it works.
I want a wooden snowman, but no one sells them. I'll be right out.
Oh, I would be surprised if they do. Pardon me. Pardon me. My apologies.
What was this going to be for the region?
My apologies. North,
I can't get enough of YouTube. And I mean, the things that people think up of and they film, oh, it's so great. Hey, I have a question that I want you to ask everybody in your house. And I want you to be completely honest with this one. All right, today's discussion question is, how do you know if something is good or bad to watch? Yeah, how do you know? I mean, how do you know if something is good for you to watch or if it's bad for you to watch? Go ahead and talk about that and we'll be right back. Are in your homes, you know, I was thinking about you. I was thinking, you know what? They're probably watching a lot more stuff than they usually watch. So today I wanted to share with you truth from God's word about what's good for you to watch and what are some things that you should really avoid watching because they'll really hurt you from the inside out. And so what we're going to do is we're going to discover some truth from God's word. So here's what I want you to do quickly. I want you to go grab your Bible. Go find your Bible, whether it's a printed copy, whether it's a digital copy, whether it's on an iPad or a phone or something. Quick, pause this video right now. Go ahead, pause it, and then go get your video. Ready? Pause. Okay, and we're back. Got your Bible? We're going to play a game called Sword Drill. In this game, I'm going to say a verse from the Bible. The first person to find this verse in the Bible will be the winner. Now, here's how you play in your house. You have to close your Bible. If it's an electronic Bible, you have to turn off that device. Then, I want you to put this on your lap, and I want you to put your hands up way up high in the air. All right, so Bible's closed, hands up in the air, wave them like you just don't care. All right, you guys ready to play? I'm going to share the verse. First one to find it's going to be the winner today. The verse is Proverbs 4:23. That's right, Proverbs 4:23. First person to find it will be the winner. Finding that in your Bible. Here, you guys ready to discover what God's word says about the things that we watch or listen to or read? All right, Proverbs 4:23. Here's what it says, and this is written by the wisest man that ever lived. His name was Solomon. Now, this guy was crazy smart. Like, if you read the rest of Proverbs, I mean, there is incredible wisdom in here that will totally shape your life to be who God really created you to be and have the best life ever. Well, here's what he wrote in Proverbs 4:23. He says, above else. Now he's like, listen, above else, meaning this is like top priority, super duper important. Listen to what I'm about to say because this is big important stuff. He says, above all else, guard your heart. Your heart. Not like put like a piece of metal over it so that arrows come and ding off of it. We'll get to that in a second. But he says, guard your heart. And here's why. Guard your heart, for everything you do flows from it. Okay, here it is, the whole verse again. It says, above all else, guard your heart, for everything you do flows from it. Interesting, interesting. You see, what we're gonna learn today is that our hearts, what we shape and put inside of our hearts will determine all of the choices that we make. It'll determine our attitudes, the way that we treat people, the way that we even think about things. And so today, we're gonna discover, as God's word says, that we must protect our hearts because the things that we put inside of us will shape us, shape our hearts. and lead the direction that our hearts go, the ways that our hearts will flow out. It's kind of like Play-Doh. Our hearts are really soft and shapeable, just like Play-Doh is. You see, you can squish Play-Doh down, you can move it all around, you can shape it into whatever you want. And our hearts, just like Play-Doh, based on what we do with it. If we put a bunch of stuff that's gonna shape our hearts into a mess, well, then our hearts will be a mess and the rest of our lives will become a mess. But if we shape our hearts to look more like Jesus, well, then our lives will look more like Jesus and we'll have the happiest life ever. So today, we're gonna discover how can we apply God's word, his truth, to our lives on what we watch, read, or listen to. I mean, there is so much to watch, so much to listen to, so many books to read, especially when we don't have a ton of school to do. Oh man, that's the dream, right? Video games all day. But how do you know what's good? I mean, what's gonna shape your heart in a good way? So I have three simple ways for you to know what's good for you to watch and what's bad for you to watch. Tip number one, when you're watching something, I want you to think about this. If Jesus were sitting right next to you, would he be cool with what you're watching? Or would he look at you and say, you really should not be watching this. This is not gonna make you more like me. Tip number two, if you're watching something that you know is really not a good thing to be watching and your parents walked in the room, would you have to change it really quick or would you be like, oh yeah, yeah, this is what I'm watching?
Oh, hi mom. I'm just watching Daniel Tiger. okay.
If you feel comfortable enough that if Jesus were sitting right next to you and your parents walked into the room, that they would be okay and totally cool with what you're watching, well then guys, watch on. And then tip number three, is what you're watching something that's gonna make you think more about Jesus and the ways of God? Or do you think it's gonna be something that's gonna distract you and make you think less about who God created you to be and how to treat other people more like Jesus?
Yeah.
So real quick recap on, hey, three tips for you to know what's good to watch and when you shouldn't be watching it. Number one, if Jesus was sitting right next to you, would he be cool with what you're watching? Number two, with what you're watching, would you have to change the video if your parents walked in the room or would they be totally okay with it? And then finally, is what you're watching making you think more about Jesus and the ways of God or is it distracting you and making you think some really weird thoughts? Now, trust me, I get it when you say, but Pastor Josh, the picture for the video, it just looks so interesting. Or I've heard a lot of people talking about it and they say it's cool and their moms and dads let them watch it. Now, trust me, I get it. And there's some truth from God's word about how the Holy Spirit can help us in those moments when we are so tempted to just watch that 30-second video that looks so interesting, but we know it's wrong. The Holy Spirit can help us. Guys, I want to show you how that works.
Every day, we have a choice of what we're going to watch. Either the good stuff, things that will make us more like Jesus, think about Jesus, think about the ways that we can act more like him in our daily lives. Or we can watch the bad stuff, things that will scare us, that our parents don't approve of, things that will begin to change the way we think about God into a really not good way, that we start thinking even bad about people. You know, sometimes the bad stuff just pops up. Like you're watching something and then a bad thing just shows up. In those moments, it can be really hard to not watch the bad stuff. You see, every day we have a choice to either watch the good stuff or the bad stuff. Now, I have with me over here a vase or a vase. And what this vase is, we're gonna pretend that this is us. And every day we choose to either watch the bad stuff or watch the good stuff. You see, when we watch the good stuff, we become better. We become more like Jesus, our lives are better. When we watch the bad stuff, that's when we start to fall into sin. When we start to become somebody that we don't want to be, that's when we get into trouble. And what can be really hard is to not watch the bad stuff because it looks so interesting, or other people are talking about it, or it just popped up and I'm just interested and curious and I want to watch it. But the bad stuff will always lead to us being hurt. And that's where the Holy Spirit comes in. You see, we're going to pretend that this bottle right here, this BGMC bottle, is the Holy Spirit. And every day that we spend time in the Bible reading, hearing what God wants to say to us, every time we spend time with the Holy Spirit praying and saying, Holy Spirit, make me more like you. Help me to think the way that you think. Jesus told us that he would fill us with his Spirit, the Holy Spirit. And with the power of the Holy Spirit inside of us, we'll become more like Jesus. The Holy Spirit will be able to change the way that we think. The Holy Spirit will shape us and form us from the inside out to be more like him. And what will happen then is in those moments, when the bad stuff shows up, you see, we'll be starting to head in that direction. But instead, the Holy Spirit will say, no. I want you to go towards the good stuff. I want you to head in the other direction. Come on, that's gonna hurt you. Don't go that way. And the Holy Spirit will nudge you. He'll poke you and say, no. You know that's wrong. Don't do that. The Holy Spirit will give you the strength, instead of heading towards the bad stuff, to go, whoop, opposite direction. We're gonna go towards the good stuff. We're gonna watch the things that are good for us. You see, by ourselves, it's easy to go to the bad stuff. With the help and the power of the Holy Spirit inside of us, man, when we're heading in that direction, there he is to help us do the right thing. You see, God wants to help you do the good stuff. But the choice is up to you. Will you let the Holy Spirit help you? Will you let the Holy Spirit empower your life every day? Or will you fall into temptation and let the bad stuff lead your life? See, the good stuff, it'll make you more like Jesus. Your life will be happier. You'll get in far less trouble. So let's watch the good stuff. And let's allow the Holy Spirit to help us and lead us in the right way.
Today, we've learned from God's word that we must guard our hearts. You see, the things that we watch will shape our hearts. They will make us think and feel certain ways based on what we've seen happen on the screens. And so the Word of God, even before TVs were made, warns us to guard our hearts, to protect ourselves from the things that we let inside of us, because they will shape our hearts like Play-Doh. And it'll either make our hearts look really gross, or it'll make our hearts look more like Jesus. And how your heart looks, that is where the shape and the projection of your life, that's where it goes. From the heart overflows every choice we make. And so today, I want to encourage you, follow God's word. As you have more time to watch stuff at home, are you watching stuff that'll make you more like Jesus? Or are you watching stuff that will distract you and push you farther away from Jesus? So, you're going to have to make the choice. The next time you're on your TV, on your tablet, on your computer, will you make the right choice? Will you be cool watching something if Jesus was right there? He wasn't okay with it. Will you have to change the channel, change the video when your parents walk in the room? Is this thing gonna make you think and act more like Jesus? Those are the right things to watch. So you'll have to make the choice, but here, can I pray with you real quick that the Holy Spirit would help you and speak to you about making the right choices about what we watch, listen to, or read? Okay. Let's pray. Let's fold our hands real quick. Let's close our eyes. Holy Spirit, thank you so much for being our helper, our counselor, our friend. Thank you that you nudge us and push us in the right direction. Holy Spirit, I pray that this week you'd help speak to us when we're tempted to watch something we know we shouldn't. When we see a thumbnail and we think, ooh, that looks really interesting, but we know that it's not going to lead us to a good place. Lord, when we start to watch something and something pops up in the middle of it that just, ooh, it just doesn't feel right. Holy Spirit, please give us instruction, nudge us in the right direction to not watch the things that'll be bad for us. We love you, Lord. Thank you so much for helping us become more like you and have the best life ever. In Jesus' name we pray. Everyone said, amen. Nice job. Now, this is where it becomes hard. I mean, you're gonna have to really do this for yourself this week. So if you're having a hard time, talk to your parents. If you're really struggling, talk to Jesus. Ask him to help shape your heart to become more like him and make more choices like he would make. All right, guys, I am so pumped for our next digital service. We're gonna do some wild, cool things that we've never done before in our videos. So guys, check that out on Sunday morning. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.